This video is going to be about rules for divisibility by the numbers 7 and 11. So let's start out with divisibility by 7. Here I've got the number 182, and I want to know whether I can divide it by 7. So the way this trick works is this. Take the last digit, which is a 2, and multiply the last digit by a 2. So 2 times 2 is 4. And now take that and subtract it from the other part of the number, the 18. So 18 minus 4 is 14. If you end up with a 2-digit number, decide whether you can divide that number by 7. And if you can, then the original number is divisible by 7. So 14 is 2 times 7, so it's divisible by 7, which means 182 is divisible by 7. Let's try this with a bigger number. Here's 2,478. I'm going to take the last digit, the 8, and multiply that by 2. So 2 times 8 is 16. I'll subtract that 16 from the other part of the number, the 247. 247 minus 16 is 231. Now, I haven't ended up with a 2-digit number yet, so I'm going to repeat my process. I'm going to start again. I'm going to take the 231, I'll take the last digit of that number, the 1, multiply it by 2, 1 times 2 is 2, and subtract that from the other part of the number, the 23. So 23 minus 2 is 21. Now I'm down to a 2-digit number. When I get to a 2-digit number, I see if that's divisible by 7. So 21 is 3 times 7, so it's divisible by 7. That means my original number, 2,478, is also divisible by 7. Now, to do this, you do have to know all the 2-digit numbers that are divisible by 7. But once you've got those math facts, then you can look at any larger number, no matter how big, and decide whether you can divide that by 7. Okay, so here's how we decide whether a number is divisible by 11. I've got these three numbers here. I'm going to start with 2,948. To decide whether I can divide this by 11, I'm going to take the digits in the odd positions starting from the right end of the number. So going from the right, the first digit from the right is an 8. So that's an odd position. And the third digit from the right is a 9. So the first and third positions are odd positions. I'll take those two digits, the 9 and the 8, and add them together. So 9 plus 8 equals 17. Now I'm going to take the remaining digits, the ones that are in the even positions, starting from the right end of the number. So that's going to be the 2 and the 4. And I'll add those together. So 2 plus 4 equals 6. And then I'm going to subtract the smaller number from the bigger number. 17 minus 6 is 11. At the end of this process, if I end up with an 11, or a multiple of 11, or a 0, then my original number was divisible by 11. Since I've ended up with an 11, 2,948 is also divisible by 11. Let's try that with the next number, 2,750. So the odd positions from the right are going to be the first position where the 0 is, and the third position where the 7 is. So I'll add 7 plus 0. So 7 plus 0 is, of course, just 7. And then I'll add the remaining digits, the remaining positions, the even positions. That's where I've got a 2 and a 5. So 2 plus 5 equals 7. When I subtract, 7 minus 7 is 0. And remember, if I end up with a 0, an 11, or a multiple of 11, then the original number is divisible by 11. And now here's a bigger number, 580,624. So my odd positions are going to be the first position from the right, where the 4 is, the third position where the 6 is, and the fifth position where the 8 is. So I'll add together 8 plus 6 plus 4. So I've got a 6 and a 4. I'll add those together and get a 10. And then 8 more is 18. And then I'll add together the remaining positions, the even positions. So that's the 5, the 0, and the 2. So 5 plus 0 plus 2. 5 plus 0 is 5. Plus 2 more is 7. I'll subtract the smaller number from the bigger number, so 7 from 18. I've got an 11. So this number, this large number, 580,624, is divisible by 11. Okay, so that's divisibility by the numbers 7 and 11. Take care. I'll see you next time.